The objective of this video is to learn how to make a prediction about a dependent variable using a linear regression equation. The table shows the correlation between number of releases of new movies per studio and gross receipts in millions of dollars. We are to predict the gross receipts for a studio that releases 200 new movies. Using a tool such as a TI graphing calculator, as shown in a previous video, we can find the linear regression equation that relates these variables. That equation is y prime equal to 181.661 plus 7.319x, where the independent variable x represents the number of releases and the dependent variable y represents the gross receipts. You should use these guidelines when making predictions for the dependent variable using a regression line. 1. The points of the scatter plot fit the regression line reasonably well. So we will begin by constructing a scatter plot for the ordered pairs for the correlated data. We will assign number of releases as the x variable and gross receipts as the y variable. Plotting the linear regression equation y prime equal to 181.661 plus 7.319x on the same set of axes shows us that there is a reasonable random scattering of the observed ordered pairs on either side of the regression line. The second guideline is that the value of r must be significant. R, the correlation coefficient for this set of data, is 0.880. We will conduct a hypothesis test about the significance of the correlation coefficient. We will begin by stating the hypotheses. The null hypothesis is rho equal to 0, and the alternative hypothesis is rho not equal to 0. We will use a level of significance, alpha equal to 0.05, for this hypothesis test. The procedure for finding the p-value can be found in previous videos in this chapter. The p-value for the significance of the correlation coefficient for this set of data is 0.0017. Since the p-value is less than alpha, we should reject the null hypothesis. Since we are rejecting the null hypothesis, we will conclude that the value of r is significant. As long as the rest of the guidelines are met, we may use the model to make predictions about gross receipts. The third guideline is that the value of a specific x is not much beyond the observed values in the original data. The x values for this data set span from 8 to 361. An x value of 200 is well within this range. The fourth guideline is, if r is not significant, then the best predicted value for a specific x value is the mean of the y value in the original data. In this case, we found r to be significant, so we will use the linear regression equation to make our prediction. Y prime, the symbol for the predicted value of the dependent variable, represents gross receipts, and x, the independent variable, represents the number of releases. So we will substitute 200 into the linear regression equation for the number of releases. This gives us a predicted gross receipts value of $1,645.5 million. The predicted correlation of 200 new movie releases and $1,645.5 million in gross receipts is represented by the point 200, 1645.5, that lies on the regression line. In this video, we learned how to make a prediction about a dependent variable using a linear regression equation.